Hi everyone, welcome back to IL-2 Great Battles. Here we are, flying by the moonlight. We're on a solo run tonight. Yes, we're up in the IL-2 Light Bomber. This incredible fighter, which the game series has been named after. It would be wrong to look at all these potential career aircraft and not bring the IL-2 into it. Stumovik. So here we are. We're flying, night configuration. Now we've got rockets and bombs on board, and we're going to try and attack some enemy positions. So I think they've got some vehicles, potentially armored vehicles. So we need to just fly by the light of the moon and make our way to the location and see if we can do some more bombing in this beautiful aircraft. Hi everyone. Right, down there. We have lights. Oh, searchlights are on. Let's get... Okay, still trying to dodge these searchlights. We don't want them picking us up. You can see the headlights of the traffic. But corkscrewing away seems to have temporarily given us a bit of refuge from these lights. Right, there are the headlights coming down the main street. Let's go in with bombs. There we go. Okay, you see what we're doing now. Been struck by some aircraft fire. Right, we've got some burning wreckage, which means we've hit something with the bombs. We've got some more lights still, so we're going to come in again. Maybe we should finish off those searchlights. Oh, and then aircraft fire tracers whizzed across the canopy there. Still doing so, yeah. Let's get some space and we'll come back. The aircraft fire is so intense and so accurate. Let's see if we can take out some of these searchlights. We've got some rockets as well. We might use the rocket. Oh, hello. There's one right down there. Hello. Thank. Oh, there's another convoy coming in. Oh, no. I can't go straight into it. Oh, exactly. I can't go straight into it. We're pulling heavy left. Trying to keep the aircraft alive. We sustained heavy damage. Right. Okay, aileron's pretty much tattered. We have to do light turns now, otherwise we may lose control of this aircraft. She's fighting to get away from me. Can you see any more of those headlights? Oh, there's the spotlight. Here comes any aircraft fire. Oof, we just took a hell of a beating. Right, this is a tough aircraft. It's tougher than I am. I think we just got a bit of concussion from a, I don't know, did something come through the, yeah, something come through the canopy. That was lucky. That was almost death right there. Oh my goodness. Every town has a spotlight, it would seem. But we have some more. Oh, an aircraft fire coming in. We're going to do a dive on this. Oh god, hang on. I'm out of control, I'm out of control. Oh, that's all I could. I'm going to have to wrestle this aircraft home. She's wanting to kill me at every turn, so... What ordnance we did not spend, I'm afraid we're just going to have to take home with us and fly home and see if we can get this baby dad back. A very versatile and fantastic ground attack aircraft, and the amount of punishment we've taken, you can see by the moonlight, the damage to this aircraft. Yeah, we've got... Everything's got piercings and pinholes and anything from the anti-aircraft fire. Maybe we should have taken out the spotlights as a first. Take out the searchlights, the anti-aircraft won't be as accurate. But it is what it is, and let's see if we can get this baby home. Okay, there's home base. We're going to have to set up a bit of a... Let's get the canopy open, just in case the worst happens, which probably will in this battered aircraft. She's taken a hell of a beating. Let's get the gear down. Ooh, obviously that changes the characteristics of the flight drastically. See by how much I'm having to put in to keep her level, how badly damaged she is. Right, a bit of flapping, this is also going to affect the aircraft handling. Right, well, actually that's helped a lot, is it? I'm going to store it, put it down. Right, we'll bring it round for a bit of a short landing. Lights down, the gears down and locked, which is good. Down a little bit steep. Ooh, very steep. Ooh. Ugh, okay. We lost a bit at the end there, but Oh, just glad to be get her home, get her down, and switch off. Welcome back, everyone. Right, we're going to do a dawn attack this time. I thought the night attack was quite a short mission, so I thought you might want to see a little bit more footage. So I'm quite enjoying this. We've got an airfield which we're about to attack. Again, same loadout. We have rockets and bombs. This is the enemy airfield. So I suppose we take those hangars. And probably be... They've got fighters up. Fighters are taking off. Right. Let's get straight in and loose our bombs on those, well, they're not hangars, they're aircraft pens, aren't they? No one on the runway, so we're going to use this advantage just to come straight in, drop our bombs, and then come in with the rockets to try and tidy up. Oh, there goes the enemy aircraft. Ground and the air shakes around us as our bombs hit home. There's an aircraft fire down there. Hopefully they can't swing the guns around quick enough to get us. Right, let's provide some distraction for the rest of our guys coming in for their bomb. Oh, look at that. That looks pretty good. And there's the fighters. Right, I don't mind the fighters being on me. If it allows the other guys to come in and use their rockets and bombs. Although this is not particularly meant to be a fighter, it's Alright, let's have a look. He's circling over the airbase. That's is that friendly? Yeah. Oh, just been hit. Just about able to pull up. Not sure what happened there. I think we got hit by some anti-aircraft fire, did we? Maybe a... Oh, look at that. Came straight through the canopy there. The blood splattered all over our goggles. He's got a fighter on him. Come in. We're not in a good shape, but no, that's a Stumovik. That's a Stumovik as well. Where are these fighters then? Right, let's see if we can come in and cause some destruction here. What I'm most impressed about this aircraft is how much damage you can take. Again, we have been absolutely pummeled. I think we've been struck from below looking at some of these exit wounds. And yet we are still flying and we are still attacking the target. Let's see if we've got any more ordnance left. That's it. We are spent. Thank you. With that, mission complete. Let's return to base. Okay, as the sun comes up, we return to base. I don't know why the runway is so close to the little copse and trees. It's going to make things a little bit more challenging than they need to be. Let's open the cockpit, what's left of it. So once again, we've taken a pounding. Look at this. I'm amazed we're still in the air. Gear down. The aircraft's not handling particularly well, as always. It seems to be the way, but the fact that we can actually bring these damaged aircraft back is incredible. Yeah, they're like, you know, good at flapping. They are incredible aircraft, I have to say. Been really impressed with this. Let's try and improve the landing from last time. Again, we're landing a damaged aircraft, so any landing you can walk away from, it's good. Yeah, I just think we're coming a little bit too quick. And off the runway as well. I wonder how thick the snow is off the runway. I guess we'll find out. I dropped too much speed then, and we kind of dropped onto the runway, but we're safely down. And brakes are holding us up nicely, right. Good stuff. Unlock the tail brake and we can get off the runway. I say tail brake, I meant the tail wheel, of course. The cold is affecting my brain. So yes, the IL-2 Sturmovik. What are your thoughts? I think a very, very rugged, very robust, very stable aircraft, actually. You might be able to fly this back after sustaining so much damage. Is goodness me, it's pretty good. And obviously a lot of Russian aircraft are very utilitarian, very robust, you know, over-engineered for over-engineered for strength in many areas. It feels that way. Maybe that's not the case, but right, let's park her up here. And just before the end, I'll show you the mission summary from the airfield attack. We were awarded 3 transport kills, and that's it. So we did a lot of bombing, a lot of rocketeering, but only 3 transport vehicles were confirmed killed by us. So there's a lot of smoke and debris for 3 vehicles, but okay, that's fine. The IL-2 Sturmovik, ground attack aircraft. That's actually, could be quite fun. And it's quite a robust, I've said that for about the millionth time now. I hope you're not having the drinking game every time I say robust. You have a drink. You'd be very drunk by now. My voice is about to die because I'm not very well. Thank you ever so much for watching. We are coming to the end. I believe we have one more aircraft to look at. And after that, I'll put it up for a vote. So we'll have next week, we'll have one more aircraft to evaluate and review. And then the following week, we will have a video with a little clip of each of the aircraft we reviewed. And there'll be a poll in the video where you can put your thoughts and your where you want to put your voice behind. And you can vote for the aircraft you so wish. And from then, we'll declare the winner and we'll start a career in that aircraft. I'm looking forward to it. I hope you are too. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your continued support. Sorry you've had to listen to me in this flu-ridden state. It's not really flu, it's just a heavy cold. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.